Good morning.
Welcome to worship. Hopefully in the various work areas, I had put the note that when the church bells ring at 9:30, they stop and pause, and together, whoever's working, wherever they're working, together say the Lord's Prayer. So hopefully now the workers are saying the Lord's Prayer when they heard the bells. We thank Reverend Charles Preston for serving as liturgist and Janice Weeks for serving as greeter. The altar vase flowers are given in loving memory of their parents and grandparents, Leonard and Augusta Ohm, by Kara, Aaron, Jenny, and Drew Wright. Ian Mina McBrien put a thank you I think everyone should have a 99th birthday, flowers, a bundle of birthday cards, phone calls, and visits. It was amazing. Thank you. A reminder that new members join November 10th, 2024. So if you still want to do that, I have forms on the desk for those that haven't already filled one out. And anything strange in the bulletin is you can look to me, because our secretary was out with influenza A, according to the emergency room. She and her husband, who has Parkinson's, have influenza A. So I did the bulletin, so if there's any flubs, I did the best I could. The Brotherhood meat sale is underway, and order forms are in the back of the sanctuary. And wherever Dave Douglas is, you can find Dave. Well, but today you won't be sitting there all day. So if you want meat order forms, find Dave today, right? Or call him. And because the deadline is tomorrow. Evening Guild will meet Monday, November 4th. That's not tomorrow, but November 4th. It'll begin at 6 o'clock. And include the annual white elephant auction. Please bring no longer needed or unique items for this fun fundraising event. Our October mission of the month is donations for Shop with the Hero dinner. So, or was that November? No, that's October. Clearly mark any donations. And Trunk or Treat will be next Sunday, the 27th, 2 to 4. There'll be trunks, hopefully outside, will be the trunk time. And then there will also be a blow-up haunted walk or something in the fellowship hall. So please plan to attend. Even if you don't have kids, just come and see the fun. Come and participate. Cardinals calendars. The cemetery is again selling Cardinals calendars. It's one of the announcements I missed. Betty sent it to me this week, but it was Tuesday. I didn't know I was doing the bulletin then. So anyway, see Betty Mezeras today or in the next couple, 3 weeks to order. Betty, 2 or 3 weeks, is it? Okay, November 17th. Oh, you got lots of time. $20 for a calendar. We got them last year, too. They're really nice calendars. And that's a fundraiser for the cemetery. And let's see. I guess I probably don't need to tell you that today's our fall dinner in store. You're probably fairly aware of that. And in our upcoming events, remember the Chris Kendall Market is November 2nd. We welcome new members November 10th. Our annual meeting is November 17th. Harvest Home Toten Fest is November 24th. And then all the way to January, of course, there'll be a lot of things in between, but just a mark now for January 5th for a retirement celebration for Rusty. Looking at our, and the hurricane jar is still in the entryway for during October, we're collecting donations. In our calendar, Monday is, today's script orders. Also see Betty Mezeras today for script orders. And, see Betty, yeah. And tickets for today's dinner, probably see Betty. So hopefully she has many pockets. And Tuesday's regular, Wednesday, I think Bell Choir is moving to 5 o'clock. Kathy, right? 5? 5 o'clock. And there'll be no Chancel Choir Wednesday because Chancel Choir is rehearsing Thursday at 6 o'clock. And Church Women United is Thursday at 9:30. And band rehearsal, of course, will be in Fellowship Hall. Next Sunday, like I said, is Trunk or Treat. It's also game night, and it's also when we celebrate during worship Reformation Sunday. So if you're just really looking forward to singing A Mighty Fortress Is My God, Is Our God, plan Reformation Sunday. We always have it. Anybody else with announcements? I trust you, but I don't know about quick.
I just want to let everybody know that the Brotherhood is going to raffle a 21.5-pound ham today and during the Chris Kringle time. So it's you can buy one ticket for $1 or six of them for $5.
Wow, that's great. We appreciate all that Dave does and all that he keeps us informed on. We do appreciate it. And that he takes a little good-natured ribbing at times. Anyone else for announcements? Well, then, let us greet one another with a smile and a wave, and we will be singing. Seems like a fitting song, come to God's own temple in our harvest home. Okay, the message for God's children is again from Job. I thought there was another one. Well, there is. Oh, okay. And Job is saying, oh, come on. You know, my life is sort of the pits right now. And what are you going to do? And God answered Job saying, where were you when I laid the foundation of the earth? Tell me, if you have understanding, who determined its measurements? Surely you know. Because Job had been feeling a little bit like, okay, I know what should be happening here. I know what it should be. And God is saying, oh, I'm the one that started all. So sometimes it's possible for people to get a little bit, as they say, big for their britches. You heard that saying? When sometimes we need a little bit of a reminder that we are God's children. We are not miniature gods. We are God's children. And so we turn to God and we keep in mind that we don't always understand everything. We don't know everything. We don't control everything. And we never will. But we give our best and we trust that God is always with us. So when you have a lousy day at school, God is with you. When you have a lousy day at work, God is with you. And when you have a boring, lonely day at home,
God is with you. You're not alone. So let us give thanks that God is always with us. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for your promise that you are caring always and that you are with us always. I ask your special blessing upon those working the dinner today in so many different ways, and help them to remember that what we are doing is to serve you and to bring glory to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let us join together in the responsive call to worship and prayer. Come into God's presence.
All are welcome here.
Come into God's glory.
God's glory is all around.
As Christ came before us,
we come to worship and to pray.
As Christ turned to God,
we bring our anguish and our tears.
As Christ came to serve,
we bring our humble hearts.
Come into God's presence.
All are welcome here.
Let us unite our voices in prayer.
Great and mighty God, create us anew this day, when we both are greater and mightier than we are, to help us be humble and of service in your name. When pride causes us to stumble, strengthen our faith. When fear and shame cause us to shrink, remind us that we are made in your image. Reclaim us as the people you have created us to be, and lead us back to the path of discipleship you have called us to walk. In your great and gracious love, we pray. Amen.
Christ's love and mercy are greater than our sins, reconciling us to God and to one another. As Christ came to serve, so now Christ invites us to serve one another with peace and love.
Let us worship with joy.
Let us join in the responsive Psalter reading from Psalm 104. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are very great.
You are clothed with honor and majesty, wrapped in light as with a garment.
You stretch out the heavens like a tent. You set the beams of your chambers on the waters.
You make the clouds your chariot. You ride on the wings of the wind.
You make the winds your messengers, fire and flame your ministers.
You set the earth on its foundation so that it will never be shaken.
You cover it with the deep as with a garment. The waters stood above the mountains.
At your rebuke, they flee. At the sound of your thunder, they take to flight.
They rose up to the mountains, ran down to the valleys, to the place that you appointed for them.
You see a boundary that they may not pass, so that they might not again cover the earth.
O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Praise the Lord.
You may be seated.
Our epistle reading this morning is from Hebrews chapter 5, verses 1 through 10. Every high priest chosen from among the mortals is put in charge of things pertaining to God on their behalf, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal gently with the ignorant and the wayward, since he himself is subject to weakness, and because of this he must offer sacrifice for his own sins as well as those of the people. And one does not presume to take this honor, but takes it only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by the one who said to him, "You are my son, today I have begotten you." And as he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." And in the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Having been designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek.
And lost retirement wealth a year is what's being left on the table because people forget to invest their role. So here's the situation. We try to talk about why people need a plan. Okay, we truly believe that planning is better than no planning. So imagine this.
Well, as Dave says whenever he's rehearsing us, well, we're going to try it without Annette. Well, we're going to try it without Dave today.
There I am. Our gospel lesson today is from Mark chapter 10, verses 35 through 45. Listen for the good news of the gospel. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And Jesus said to them, "What is it you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Appoint us to sit, one at your right hand and one at your left, in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" And they replied, "We are able." And then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to appoint, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the other 10 disciples heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. Instead, whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." Thanks be to God for this lesson. May the Holy Spirit inspire the presentation and hearing of this meditation, that we might learn to love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, strength, and mind, and our neighbors as ourselves. Amen. This is a wonderful day. A wonderful day to hear Scripture encouraging us to serve one another. As we anticipate another successful dinner, accomplished with everyone's hard work. While we are trying something new this year, with a chicken and dumplings dinner rather than a sausage dinner, we are serving the community and God's church in a new, yet old way. Good food. Good ideas. Good bake sales. Good jewelry. Good items. We serve the community. If we could see through the walls and floors surrounding us in this sanctuary, we would see many people scurrying around with last-minute preparations and doing their assigned roles, some of which they'd had for many years. And for some have even taken over their roles from their parents and grandparents. Working together, we will serve several hundred dinners today. Now, of course, there has to be people in charge to keep it organized, but I don't think they are tyrants lording it over others, as our gospel lesson describes some people. No, even those who are in charge are also serving others and serving our good cause and building up cooperation among all. But now, I'm not silly enough to think that when people get overtired or stressed, I won't be a little snippy at times. Anybody here who's never been guilty of being snippy? I don't see anybody raising their hand that they've never been snippy at times. Yes, there will probably be a few harsh words or glares today, but you know, it'll be okay. Everything will work out just fine. There will also be some quiet tears or sighs with thoughts of those who are no longer here to work, and hopefully some happy reminiscing of those times and some welcoming of continuing tradition by serving together. Even in new ways, we continue to serve together. Throughout life, each follower of Christ is called to serve in ways that he or she is gifted and led. Some are led to debone chickens. Some are led in other directions, but all are needed. Some are called to ordain ministry as pastors and priests, but all are called to serve in some type of ministry. Yesterday at the Illinois South Conference annual meeting, I was recognized for the 35th anniversary of my ordination, and Reverend Alan Ryder was recognized for the 50th anniversary of his ordination, both of which we celebrated here during worship on May 5th. I don't know for sure, I can't remember exactly, but I think there was a pastor listed for celebrating either a 65 or 70 anniversary of ordination. Let's see. Kiki, do you remember? 65? Okay. I know it was more than I'll ever see anyway. Isn't that amazing? I think it's amazing. In Hebrews, the writer makes reference to Jesus being called as a priest forever. Yeah, sounds like it. According to the order of Melchizedek. Now, perhaps today, 65 years sounds like Melchizedek's forever. But it's a pretty neat name, I think, Melchizedek. Yet I've never known anybody with that name in my life. And a lot of people have biblical names, but I've never known a Melchizedek. This passage in Hebrews, though, may seem disconnected from us, not just in name, but just disconnected, if we don't know anything about who the ancient first priestly Melchizedek was. In Genesis, first book of the Bible, chapter 14, verse 18, Melchizedek is identified as the king of Salem and priest of the Most High God who offered Abraham bread and wine as he was returning from the defeat of the four kings. Then in Psalm 110, verse 4, the king being spoken to is identified as a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. And that's all we know until he is mentioned by the writer of Hebrews many centuries later, which still doesn't tell us much. Some scholars say that the writer of Hebrews linked Christ to Melchizedek to prove Jesus was superior over the priesthood of Aaron and the Levites. But others say that it is not useful to try to connect Jesus to specific people in the Hebrew scriptures. For Jesus Christ stands alone above all others as the Son of God. So to me, the reference to Melchizedek is most useful as a reminder that while Jesus is like us, he was like us as being truly human, he is beyond us as truly divine, serving and being served forever and ever. And so while we follow Jesus, we can never be honored as Jesus was, even at milestone ordination celebrations. We can never be equal to Jesus. We cannot be a high priest in the manner that he was. And to seek to achieve it, well, that would be sinful. It would be self-idolatry to claim to be Jesus' equal. In our gospel lesson, James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came close to that sin when they asked to sit on either side of Jesus in glory. Did they desire to be close to him, to bask in his glory, maybe to get their own little, you see those pictures where there is light around Jesus' head? Maybe they wanted their own little halos or whatever. Or did they desire to be close to him because they loved him and they didn't want to be separated from him? Or were they afraid of harm and thought they would be safe being close to Jesus? Little did they know, or understand, I should say. But if I had to guess, I think they wanted some glory. especially since the other disciples essentially saw them as big-headed egomaniacs for even asking. Maybe James and John had a Messiah complex before it was labeled as such. Yes, they were followers of Jesus, but maybe they came close to lording it over others. And what did Jesus do about that? He set them straight, that they were not so smart and special, but in a kind way. We know that Jesus' glory was not as they expected, because his glory was on the cross with criminals on his right and left. James and John did not knowingly ask to be on the cross on Jesus' right and left. Even though Jesus had spoken to them about his coming crucifixion, they could not completely understand or accept it. They still looked for human glory and prestige. So Jesus, once again, instructed them to be humble servants, to follow the example of serving others. That was their call, to be servants of others. Jesus didn't get mad and kick them out of discipleship. He didn't side with the other disciples or mock them. Jesus gave them another lesson and another chance to understand and do what he asked of them. And he does the same for us, gives us another chance. He gives us opportunity after opportunity to correct our mistakes. He forgives our sins, and he calls us to live as his faithful disciples, serving others. This is true for every Christian and every church, even St. Elizabeth's having a turkey dinner today on our day. We are to stand as examples of service that is not about dominating, controlling, or tricking others. It is not about self-gratification or prestige. Christian service is about representing God's unfailing love, which is greater than anything else known to humankind. Christian service is about sharing with a world that sometimes forgets or denies God's love. So how does the world remember or see God's love? They see it in us. They see it in all who follow Jesus by serving others in his name. May we do so with humble joy. Amen. That's a long ways removed from what we're singing. Thank you. You may be seated. As we begin our time of prayer, I lift prayers for my friend Kevin Lee. His wife Nancy Spearley was ordained, 20 some years ago anyway. And she has preached here a couple of times years ago, filling in. Kevin is in ICU at Barnes, had a bad fall, had serious back surgery. He got off the ventilator into this week, so prayers for him. I've been told that Marilyn Robertson has COVID. Jack and Sandy had COVID, but Jack looks pretty good. All going well? Yep. Okay. They're past that. Ooh. The way some people use the word past, I better not say that. They're recovered. Before I go into all the ones in the bulletin, any others? Linda? So an aunt in Florida survived everything, and Dennis' surgery went very well, and he was a very good patient. And Kiki. So today is Marilyn's birthday. We were going to get to sing to her. She's not on Zoom, is she? I didn't hear any of that, but so we're going to sing happy birthday anyway. Okay, George, start us out. Oh, they've got it. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Marilyn. Happy birthday to you. Yes, that'll be special. Okay, those in nursing assisted and independent living, Bob Braunmeier, Marcia Binger, Ruth Buer, Hilde Few, Cletus Knobloch, Karen Ludeke, and Lucille Mangoff. At home, Chloe Affalter, Isabella Boyer, Sandy Dawson, Lucard Fries, Keith Grady, Melba Grady, Lou Hassey, Mina McBrien, Cindy Meyer, Bev Partney, Reverend Alan Ryder, June Stilley, Trish Strumland with us again today, yeah. Janice Weeks with us, Mary Whitehead, our secretary, as I said, she has influenza A, and Nancy Wilson. And in the Illinois South Conference, St. Jacob UCC, Reverend Philip Barbier, Staunton St. Paul UCC, Reverend Joshua Pittman, and Reverend Tiffany Pittman, retired pastor Reverend Kenneth and Jean Knobloch. And I sort of did things out of order. Are there any additional concerns or celebrations? Kara? Yeah, Kara's 94-year-old aunt is in the hospital and not responsive at this time. Dorothy? Yes, a wonderful birthday. Can I say the number for Dorothy? 95 for Dorothy. Anyone else? Then let us be in a spirit of prayer. As faithful disciples, we come to you, O God, in prayer. Many things are on our mind today. We are filled with joys and concerns. It's wonderful to work together on this dinner and country store as a church family of all ages, to gather around tables with friends and family and strangers, and to share life as your people. The scents and the sounds and the sights all blend together to offer hospitality and the rewards of hard-earned funds. Keep everyone safe and in good spirits, we pray. And as we eat more than we might need to, remind us of those who never have enough to eat. Help us to be compassionate and willing to find ways to help feed the world. As we greet friends, remind us of those who are lonely and troubled. Help us to be genuinely friendly and willing to reach out to others, especially those who are outcast. Many of us have concerns that are tearing us up inside. Remind us that your spirit of peace is with us always. Help those who grieve the death of loved ones find peace. Help those whose families are torn by conflict and distrust find peace. Help those who worry about children or parents and their decisions that cannot completely be controlled or understood find peace. Help those who have health problems and questions find answers and healing if possible, and through your compassion, find peace. Throughout the world, there are struggles, too many to be named, many we don't even hear about because they are not top priority or big news items. Yet we know you care about everyone, every person, every part of your creation. Show us, we pray, how we can make a difference and spread your love through our mission work. For we want to be faithful disciples, truly serving others. Give us guidance and courage as we serve and pray in Jesus' name, now together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
As we present our offerings, we share our time, our talent, our treasure. The treasure that we bring today is always given for God's glory, and so we give thanks for this opportunity. Somebody's crying.
join me in the unison prayer of dedication. Great and gracious God, as you have blessed our lives and all of creation, bless the gifts we now return to you. Bless our hands and our lives, that they may serve you and your creation. Continue creating life and hope through our offerings and our ministries. May the glory and our grace shine through everything we do, everything we say, and everything we do. In loving gratitude we pray. Amen.
Come together to worship and give thanks to God, and we are willing to go out and serve, whether in today's work, tomorrow's work, and forever. Let us go in the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.